to my little family of vases. Today's video, as you can probably tell, it is going to be all about my vase collection, which is literally on the table in front of me. Okay, that's a bit better. I'm a little bit closer now. You can kind of hear me better. Don't have to shout as much. But yes, I'm going to talk to you about all my vases. I will try and link them all in the description box below. Some of them are kind of old or like in independent stores in Brighton, or they could currently be sold out. But like I said, I will try and link them below. If not, I will try and find something which is kind of similar. But yeah, I'm gonna get started. So if you follow me on Instagram, then you probably know that I do love H&M Home. They do some really beautiful vases. They hook me in every time I see one online. I don't know what it is, but they do it right. So a lot of my vases are from H&M, beware. But I'm gonna start with H&M first and get that out of the way. So I've got this vase here. I absolutely love the kind of rainbow shape. This is the really lovely rough ceramic material. And it's a really gorgeous color as well. It's just a very neutral beige off white. But it fits in with a lot of interior, so it's really easy to match. When you have flowers in there, it looks really cool. Continuing with that ceramic material, I then got this one here. It's more kind of like, I don't know how to describe this one. I think this one's like wavy or like donuts. I don't know. This is one of my favorite vases at the moment. I absolutely love it. It's so heavy as well, but I love it. It makes flowers look so cool. I believe they did it in a small version as well, but I think the small version just sold out like that. But I will try and link it below. But yeah, this one lives in the bedroom at the moment. And then also have this cute little one here. Again, it's the exact same material with the ceramic and the speckles. Yeah, this one looks adorable when you have loads of little flowers in there. So I think this one was like $8.99. Oh, continuing the ceramic fill of vases, I picked up this one here. This one is a very new addition, so it's quite recent, but I just love how weird it is. Like, it's a really bizarre shape, and yeah, I think it's so cool. They do it in a really big version as well, and they also do it in a black color. The black color is stunning, but I'm just not the black wouldn't really suit my kind of like home interior color scheme. I don't know, like, I just feel like the black would be a bit too harsh. It's not kind of what I'm after or what I like. Continuing little vases, I picked this one up here. I really loved this color. It's a beautiful dark brown color. I love the fact it has like the little black speckles as well, and then it's got the cute little handles. It's just really, really sweet. It's actually funny because most people have an addiction with like shoes or handbags. Mine's clearly vases. Next, we have this one here. This one, I believe, when did I get this one? I want to say end of last year, I think. So end of 2019, possibly. I got it when I was going through that phase of like the kind of doodle vases. And to be honest, I still love it. I really do love it. And I don't think I use it enough, to be honest. It's just in the bedroom and it has dried flowers in it. But I think, you know, I should use it for more fresh flowers. Yeah. But yeah, I love this one, and it's a really good size as well. And to be honest, the fact like it has a face on it, if I ever go off the face, I can just turn it around and I have a plain one. So another cream vase I have is this one here. This one was sold out online for God knows how long. And then I went into the H&M Home store in London and I saw this in there and I was like, oh my God, I need to get it. And I'm so glad I did. I love it. I love it so much. It's kind of weird. It's like, it looks like it's cracked, but it's not. That's just the effect. But I love the fact it's bobbly and like the texture. I think when it comes to vases, I love something which is really textured. And with this, it just looks sick. I love it. I love it so much. They did do it in several other colors as well. I believe they did it in a clear, a black, and a yellow. I don't know whether any of those are still available, because this was like springtime that I got this. Oh, I forgot about this one. Yeah, this is that rough ceramic material like I showed you first. I love this vase. Again, it's a really bizarre shape, and it's just slightly different. Do you know what I mean? It just looks so cool on the shelf. This is the small version. They do it in a larger version, which I didn't buy, which I kind of regret now. But it's fine. I am still happy with this one. At the moment, I've currently just got some pampas grass in here. If you're wondering where the pampas grass is from, it's from Sun and Day. Okay, so the next few vases, they aren't the typical kind of like rustic ceramic kind of film of vases. They're slightly different. I don't know why I have these, to be honest. I think they don't really fit my style anymore, but I'm too attached to them to throw them out. So they will be staying no matter what. First one is this one here. It's huge. It's so huge. And it's kind of shiny, which I'm not sure whether I'm a fan of anymore. And yeah, I don't really know whether I do like it, but it's kind of cool. I love like how weird it is. It reminds me of coral. But yeah, I rarely ever use this one, to be honest. It just sits in the corner of the flat. But I'm like, I don't want to sell it. Because if I sell it, I feel like I'd really regret it and then I'd really miss it. We then have this one here. Again, I'm not quite sure whether this is my style, to be honest. It's a lady. She got her boobs out and then cheeky bit of bum as well. I don't know whether this is my style at all. Do you know what I mean? You can really picture it in like a modern contemporary style of house, whereas the decor that I love is very kind of like rustic, homemade, textured. So I don't really feel like this fits in with that vibe. But like I mentioned before, I would feel sad to let it go. So, but although it could just look cute on a shelf. Okay, I've got two more from H&M and then I'm done. This one's pretty boring. I got this one, my God, like maybe 2 years ago, 2 or 3 years ago? I can't remember. This was like, I think one of my first H&M home orders I done. It's just a really simple grey vase. I don't tend to use it that often. It sits in the back of the cupboard, so I kind of forgot I even had it. This is the thing though, because I live in like a flat, there's only so many vases I can use or like actually have on display. I feel like when I eventually move into my own house and I have loads of different rooms, I can then actually have all my vases out on display. Do you know what I mean? But yeah, this is like a grey glass simple vase. And then the last one is, oh my God, this one here. Now this one was actually in the sale for $7.99 online. I was like, oh my God, a bargain. I was like, yes. Didn't check the dimensions, so I didn't actually know how big it was. And it turned up and I was like, fucking hell, that is huge. I was like, I have to keep it. I paid literally like £8 for this and it's sick. I have no idea what I would use it for, to be honest. But yeah. Okay, that was all of them from H&M. I don't know if I'm rambling way too much about them. Like, does anyone actually care? I don't know. But I'm gonna try and whiz through the next vases that I have. This one here is from Wilko. I got this, can't remember. I don't really tend to use this, to be honest. I don't really like how orangey this is. I bought it because I loved how textured the terracotta part was. And it is quite a nice shape, but yeah, I'm not too keen on like how orangey this is. Next up, we have this Gluggle Jug from Oliver Bonus. I went through a phase where I was really loving this vase through, I think it was springtime. But I haven't used it in a while actually, so I think I might get it out again. But the best part is that when you actually tip the water out, it does make a gluggle noise. But Oliver Bonus, they do it in several other colours and they do it in a slightly smaller size as well. But yeah. Then we have this little guy here. His name is Bert. he's actually a plant holder, but I guess you could maybe use him as a vase. I don't know. But he is from Bert's homeware store. I don't think you can buy anything from Bert's home store online. I don't think you can. But yeah, this little guy here. Look how cute he is. There is also a girl version as well, but I preferred the guy. be honest. Got this little one here. This is just from a charity shop. I think this one was like £2 or something. But I really love the glass. It's like a beautiful kind of pale green color. Oh my god, look, it matches my nail. yeah, this looks really sweet on a vase. No, this looks really sweet on a shelf. And sometimes I put like a single flower in there as well, which looks adorable. This is a really old vase. I picked this up when I actually first moved into this flat, which was May last year. But this one is from Urban Outfitters Home. They did release a smaller version as well. I don't know if these are still available anymore, but I'll make sure I link them below if they are. Next up is this one here. This one is from a small independent store in Brighton, which is called Abode Living. I love the little handles and it's a beautiful pale terracotta color. It's not the same color as this. Do you see what I mean? Like this one looks just looks really, really like harsh and bright, whereas this one's much more subtle and neutral. Does that make sense? But yeah, it's got the really nice rough ceramic feel and it's a really cute little size and I just love this one. Next up is this here. It's the Cheeky Vase from Rose and Grey. And I kind of like as well the fact that this girl has like a few little muffin tops. Can you see? I love it. It's just like a normal body. So yeah, got a little cheeky bum there and then the front. This is a really nice smooth ceramic. And again, I don't tend to use this for flowers. This is mainly just for decoration on the mantelpiece. I also have this vase here, which is from IKEA. It's a baby pink color. To be honest, I don't really like it at all. I hate the fact that it's pink. It's not my kind of style anymore at all. It's, for some reason, it's still in the cupboard. But yeah, I thought, you know, this is a vase and it's part of the collection, so I'll show it. But it's not my favourite vase and I probably will be saying goodbye to it pretty soon. Got this cute little one here, which is from Sassen Bell. It's got a smooth glazed top and then the bottom is a rough ceramic, which is textured. It's a really cute little size as well. Sassen Bell do really nice tiny little vases if you're after like a small one. Next vase we have is this one here. This one is from Zara Home. This is actually called a pot stand. I saw Monique on Instagram have it and she sold it to me. It looks so nice on her dining room table. This is the small version and there is a larger version as well. In the middle of a dining room table, this is stunning. So, and then the last two vases are from Habitat. So I'm gonna start off with this one here. You don't really see this one that much on my Instagram. Purely because I have like huge, large pampas grass, you know, in it. And just in the corner of the flat. But this is from Habitat. I got this in sale for £15. So I'm not 100% sure whether it's actually available anymore. But I love the shape of it. It is ceramic as well, of course. It's got the really nice texture to it. Yeah. And then for the last vase, it is this one here. I actually have two of these, but I thought there's no point holding up to. You can just see it here. I love the texture to it. I love the fact it's got the three little tubes. It looks so cute by itself or with like single flowers in it. It's just perfect. Okay, that is all my vases, I think. I'm pretty sure that's like all of them. I will try and link them all in the description box below. And yeah, I'll probably be buying more vases, you know, as months go on. So I'll see how well this does, and if I buy loads more I may do a part two, I don't know. But I hope you all enjoy the rest of your day and I shall see you all very, very soon. Bye.